pair of teams that combined for 66 wins meet for your state Class 2A baseball championships in Peoria. It is the Cardinals from Pleasant Plains taking on the Byron Tigers. Hi again, everybody, and welcome to an overcast afternoon here in Peoria. Dave Bernhardt along with Hall of Fame coach Mark Lindo and these two teams. Mark, you talk about teams that have been able to get their maximum number of games in, and they have did it with maximum efficiency. Big time numbers for these clubs.
Well, both teams are championship caliber teams. Both teams have found different routes to get here. Byron on a nice little streak. There's no doubt that they have been playing their best baseball. And Pleasant Plains, second in the state last year. Nobody thought they'd be back, but here they are.
Last time Byron was playing in a state championship ball game, you'd have to go all the way back to 1995. Pleasant Plains, your visiting team, they'll bat first. Here's how it looks for the Cardinals. Couple of colds to lead it off. Hamilton and Greer at the top of that order for head coach Dave Greer. In the third spot, it'll be the first baseman Dylan B. Johnny Steinwart is the catcher. He hits the cleanup spot. Alex Edwards doing the designated hitting today, batting for the left fielder Dylan Skinner. Aaron Hand, the lone senior in the starting lineup for Pleasant Plains, gets six. He's in right field. Zach Ross in center. Chad Weller doing the pitching. Talk more about him later. And then rounding out the batting order will be Dalton Nibby, the second baseman for Pleasant Plains. The outfield of Dylan Garbett, Austin Carlson, and Bass Byers for Byron. Infield third to first, Tyler Rowland, Tyler Nunes, Austin Van Lenkveld, Nate Peterson. Behind the plate, it's Jack Flieger. And we're going to see lefty on the mound once again for Byron. This time it's Dan Lau.
Good look at Dan Lau, 6'5", 185 pounds. Good numbers, 8-1 on the season. He's thrown 65 and a third innings with a sparkling 1.93 earned run average. Lau has punched out 81 opponents while walking just 20. Good movement on his fastball, sharp breaking curveball, presence on the mound, and leading off this baseball game, Cole Hamilton, and to call the title game, the Hall of Fame Boys from Illinois High School Association 2A state championship, Dave Bernhardt.
Thank you very much, Mark. We are ready to roll, looking to beat the weather that is moving into the Peoria area. The first pitch from Lau down and in a little bit to Cole Hamilton. Hamilton 1-for-2 in the 5-2 win over Freeburg in the semifinals. A three-run sixth inning for Pleasant Plains. Punched their ticket here to the championship ball game for the second year in a row. On the other side, Byron knocked off Westmont 6-2 after trailing 2-0, a couple of three-run innings. The difference in that ball game.
Cole Hamilton, 27 stolen bases. He scored 39 runs. When he gets on base, a lot of good things happen for Pleasant Plains, who does have a pretty strong offense up and down.
That pitch hits Hamilton. He's going to find himself down at first base. At least he gives the indication he was hit. And now we'll get a little conference. I never saw the umpires call it. Jim Hayden working to make that, Tim Griffin working the plate here in his state championship. Ryan Lakaitis at first and Jay Jarrett at third. And Dave Greer does not like this call by Tim Griffin.
Well, basically, Hamilton thinks he got hit, said he got hit, ran down to first base as he got hit, but it was never called a hit batsman by Tim Griffin. So they're going to bring him back. And if he didn't see it, if he didn't hear it, then he's making the proper call.
So Hamilton will get that bat handed to him by Cole Greer. He'll step back in the batter's box. Count is 2-1. Now 3-1. Just underway here. Push the action ahead. In fact, this second place game is being played about 3 hours, about 4 hours actually, earlier than scheduled, trying to make sure they can get it in as Hamilton walks, get it in before a weather storm moves into the area. So everything rushed along. And in fact, even for this game, no infield for either of the teams. The time frame between games was compressed. So everybody having to settle down here a little bit early as you see the weather that is headed to Peoria right there in the middle of your screen.
Won't be long. You know what? That's not a shower, is it? That's a big old blob is what that is. It could cause some havoc on baseball.
Cole Greer, freshman, stands at the plate. He is the freshman son of the head coach, Dave Greer.
Remember, five innings is an official championship. A championship could be crowned after five innings being an official game.
lefty on the mound. Hamilton, you mentioned his base stealing numbers. His teams don't get an opportunity to really scout each other. Byron, of course, from the Rockford area, Pleasant Plains. Here's Springfield. And we will have to keep an eye on Dan Lau to see what the variety of moves that he will give you over at first base.
Good left-handers will use a slide step. They'll use a high leg. They'll use a glide step. Right there, a slide.
There goes Hamilton. Greer swinging away. Lifts it into right center field. That wind will knock it down a little bit. The catch made by base Byers. And Hamilton will hustle back out number one.
Good base running by Cole Hamilton because he had a good break. He went on the leg move. As soon as Lau picked up his leg, Hamilton was running. At the same time, though, he found the baseball, hit and run. He stayed out there until he knew it was going to be caught, and then he sprinted back to first base easily.
Just got a look at Dave Greer in his 25th season, 587 victories. He already has won a state championship that in 2000. Dylan B steps in now for the Cardinals. Won a championship in 2000, as we said, second place last year. Third place trophy for Pleasant Plains in 95, and a fourth place trophy in 2004. So you talk about filling up a trophy case, 1, 2, 3, and 4. He's gonna get another one here in a couple of hours.
21 years with 20 plus wins, 9 sectional titles. He's coached girls basketball in the past. He coached at Rochester, 13 regional titles. His lineage goes on and on.
Hamilton, a lead, trying to get as many moves as he can out of Lau. At the plate, Dylan B, the first baseman. He was 1 for 2 with the run scored and 1 driven in yesterday. There goes Hamilton again. B swings through it. The throw from Flieger, not even close. Stolen base for Hamilton.
Hamilton did a great job going on first movement. Sometimes you guess right, sometimes you guess wrong. But as soon as Lau lifted the leg, Hamilton was already in a dead sprint. No chance at all for Flieger as Pleasant Plains runs with reckless abandon.
2 balls and 2 strikes. This is a Pleasant Plains team that's not the same team that folks in Peoria saw last year. That second place team that lost to Lyle in the championship ball game. Well, 9 seniors off that club and left, including 7 starters. It's a whole new bunch here for the Cardinals here in 2014.
You got a good picture from the center field camera of Cole Hamilton leading off second. See him right there? And don't be surprised if you see these guys take off. They love to steal third base as well.
Held on by Nunez. This one is skied to center field. Carlson, the wind starting to move it a little bit. Hamilton slipped just as he was ready to push off that bag. Don't know that he would have attempted to come to third, but just kind of slipped and went down to a knee, 2 outs. The wind at about 15 miles per hour blowing from the right field foul pole to the left field pole. It's 81 degrees here. We've pretty much played today under cloudy skies. Flags there in deep left center field. The pennants above the scoreboard. A little bit lighter. They have been fluttering all day long. That brings us to Johnny Steinwart, the catcher for Pleasant Plains. Steinwart, just a sophomore, 333 average. He's driven in 23 runs yesterday, 0 for 3.
Chance have to put his team up. Good job by Byron. I know that wasn't a great pickoff play, but we had just talked about their ability to steal third. Looks like confusion between shortstop and pitcher there. Lau was looking for the opportunity, but nobody at the base at that point.
This is a great defensive team for Byron. We have committed 4 errors in 6 postseason games. Got an outstanding pitching. Yesterday it was Nate Peterson that did the job for Byron. Peterson went all 7 innings, pushed his record to 13-0, struck out 10, only allowed a couple of runs and 5 hits. Steinwart hits this one hard, hooking, and foul. It's 3-10 down the line. He could have taken that bend out of it. He may have had something there.
Call that just a little bit too much top hand. He got the top hand through the zone a little bit too quick. If he could have waited just, you know, a tenth of a second or less, he would have been able to keep that one fair.
Lau ahead in the count, 0-2. catcher Fleeger will keep it right there.
Well, Lau went with a back foot breaking ball. He wanted to throw the ball right at the back foot of Steinwert. And you can do that and bury it in the dirt when you trust your catcher like he does Jack Fleeger, a very solid receiver, blocker of pitches back there.
2-2, big lead, secondary lead there from Hamilton. It's a very aggressive base running team. They will put pressure on you from pitch number one.
Now, normally you don't try to steal base with two outs. You don't try to steal third base, but they'll do anything at any time.
Count remains 2-2.
Coach Greer's philosophy is put as much pressure on the defense as you possibly can, force defenses to make plays. Go, 36 wins for Byron. That's one heck of a season. State title game.
Ray Belskis, their head coach, now with 156 career wins in his seventh season. See the number twos there at the bottom of your screen. Hamilton breaks for third, but Steinwert will strike out to end the inning. So Hamilton leads off the walk. He steals second base, but that is where he is stranded. We'll head to the bottom of the first here in your 2A title game. Home team today, the Byron Tigers. We've mentioned 36-5 under head coach Ray Belskis. They're batting order looks like this. Leading it off will be the shortstop, Tyler Nunez. Austin Carlson, the center fielder, hits second. Jack Fleeger behind the plate hits third. Ben Rybels, the designated hitter, and he will hit for the second baseman, Austin Van Lengfeldt. Dan Lau, pitcher, bats fifth. Tyler Rowland in that. Six bodies at third base. 7-8-9 belong to Nate Peterson, the first baseman, Dylan Garbutt in left, and the right fielder base, Byers. Defensively, for Pleasant Plains, Dylan Skinner, Zach Ross, and Aaron Hand. Your outfield, third base is Hamilton. Cole Greer is shortstop. Dalton Dibby at second. Dylan B plays first. Johnny Steinwart behind the plate. And Chad Weller is going to get the call here today in your championship game.
Good look of the tall right-hander, number 21 in the Cardinal red. He's 6-2 on the season. Has a chance to win his team the state championship. He's got 26 walks to go along with those 85 strikeouts you see on your screen. A solid 1.33 earned run average in 68 and two-thirds innings pitched. A nice repertoire of pitches he will throw at you. Mid-80s slider. He's grown, he's matured. His brother was a pitcher. He's learned from the best.
And he will face Tyler Nunez stepping in. Nunez, 1-for-2, scored two runs out of that leadoff spot yesterday in the 6-2 win over Westmont.
Yeah, Chad's brother Kyle pitching for Lipscomb University, Nashville, Tennessee, a Division I pitcher.
Almost grazed the sleeve of Nunez. He's a little disappointed. He didn't kind of hang in there a bit longer.
Well, was Nunez impressive yesterday with everything he did on the baseball field? He is a proverbial spark plug.
He handles that glove beautifully, and he's very animated in that batter's box. He is ready to go, very emotional looking player there in the box to get this lineup started for the Tigers.
Got a very busy pre-pitch ritual, doesn't he? Bat's always moving.
And that time the bat was moved by the pitcher, Chad Weller. One up, one down.
Breaking ball at 75, took a lot off it, located extremely well, outer edge of the plate. Coming off the ball a bit was Nunez, and results in strikeout and out number one.
Brings up the center fielder, Austin Carlson. Carlson, two hits and two official at bats. Also scored a run, drove one in, 409 average on the season. Very experienced Byron team. 6 3-year starters. Good cut there from Carlson. Again, these two teams got a phone call, I would assume, early this morning saying, hey, arrived at the park how about 4 hours earlier than you had planned. You know, and at this stage, I think that would be welcome by these players. I mean, they're ready to play.
They're ready to play. They want to sit in the hotel all day, and especially with any kind of rain delay. And kudos, and I mean this, to Craig Anderson, the IHSA, because at Thursday's picnic, they alerted all 8 schools, all 8 coaches, that there was weather already forecast. This was on Thursday. It's Saturday. They were had a priority to get the 2 championship games done and everybody be on call. So it was definitely planned upon by the IHSA to be ready for a would-be storm situation.
Carlson hits this ball hard past the diving Greer. Carlson makes the turn at first. He will hold up right there. It went out single. It's Byron rolling here in the bottom of the first.
Boy, that ball got through there in a hurry. He hit that ball hard. Inside out, drew it past the diving shortstop, Cole Greer. Heads down on contact. Look at the head right down the finish of the swing. And you got a pretty quick shortstop and then fleet-footed Greer, but he got the ball by him in a heartbeat.
Jack Fleeger doubled yesterday. His one hit and four at bats. Drove in two with that double. Hits from that open stance. Big secondary lead from Carlson at first base.
6'1", 180, so good sized athlete.
443 average, 41 runs batted in, and 13 doubles. Also leads this team not only in doubles, but in triples and home runs.
Interesting, I watched Carlson's lead on that last pitch. He is a base stealing threat, but look at his weight is on his left side, which is very abnormal for a guy going to try to steal a base.
There he goes. Not in time with the throw. And each team has stolen a base here in the first inning. This one belongs to Carlson.
So let's break that down a little bit more. His weight was on his backside, but that means in his mind, he knew he was going to throw it the other way. You know, he knew he was going to throw his weight, his right side, his right foot, his crossover step. So a little bit different approach to stealing a base, but it's what works for Carlson.
Fleeger swung through that last pitch to protect Carlson and now hits two hopper out to Greer. That will advance the runner to third.
So anytime the ball is hit to the shortstop's right or at him, the rule of thumb is you don't advance. When the ball is behind you, you go ahead and take third base where you can score in many more ways than if you're on second base. Wild pitch, fastball, balk, you name it.
Left-handed hitting designated hitter Ben Reibel steps to the plate. Reibel had a hit in three at-bats yesterday. 39 runs batted in, a 372 average this year. So each team has had runners in scoring position here in the first inning of your 2A championship game. Just missed on the outside corner. Outfield playing Reibel to swing late. At least hit it the opposite way. Center fielder Zach Ross shaded well towards left center. The left fielder Dylan Skinner, he's right on the line.
Yeah, he's not. He is not 10 steps from the left field line if he was sprinting out.
Carlson the lead from third. High in the air. Aaron Hand wants it and drops it, and a run will score for Byron. That ball was up there a long time. It hit the glove of Aaron Hand and comes right out. It's a sick feeling if you're a right fielder, but if you're a Byron Tigers fan, it works.
He's calling for it. He's confident with it. He's underneath it. It just hits the heel of his glove. He didn't stagger. It looked like he had full control of an easy play.
This pitch is hit to left field. Skinner, who was playing near the line, will make the catch in the bullpen area. But a two-out drop fly ball gives the Byron Tigers the early lead. 1-0. Byron after one. Early going here in your Class 2A baseball championship from Peoria, Dozer Park, in downtown Peoria. We'll go to the top of the second with Alex Edwards, the designated hitter, to lead things off here for the Cardinals from Pleasant Plains. 30 wins and 11 losses. On the mound, Dan Lau for Byron. Edwards hitting for the left fielder, Dylan Skinner. Aaron Hand on deck.
Lau, a three-sport athlete, golf, basketball, baseball. said the experience has been great. We played together since we were little guys, and now we're in the big show.
Ball hit pretty well by Edwards, driving the left fielder back, and it's over his head. Dylan Garbutt will pick it up off the wall, and that will be a leadoff double from Alex Edwards. This park has changed here in the last 24 hours. Yesterday, that would have been a routine ball to left fielder, but the bats not only are working today, the ball jumping a little bit here at Dozer Park.
Yeah, that ball carried, drop step by Garbutt. I don't know if he would have got to it anyway. He did things fundamentally sound. See, right there, he goes to the point where he thinks the ball is going, but he can't outrun the flight of the ball. And like they did yesterday, they're going to run for Edwards early on. And like yesterday, I think this is very good strategy. You get one run when you can. You worry about another run later on.
Freshman Dalton settles to run at second base. Bring up Aaron Hand. He'd like to do something to atone for that drop fly ball just moments ago. And he just might right here. Sacrifice is successful. He moves that runner 90 feet from home plate.
Great execution. He bunts the ball past the pitcher, makes the third baseman field the ball. Roland did a good job, but he slid his top hand up on the bat. Watch it right there. Very, very loose grip. Keeps a barrel above the ball. Does everything fundamentally sound, fundamentally correct, and draws the Byron infield in right now. Not now, they're going to go back. They were in, and then move back.
That will bring Zach Ross to the plate.
I mean, if you would just come here, whatever. Like right there when they come off, you know what I mean? It happens sporadically when the director
big, comes. Slow curveball at 59 miles per hour. A little bit faster. It will hang up for Carlson. Tagging is Settles. Here's the throw. And Settles will score. Fleeger unable to hang on to it. It was a top hop for him. And we're tied at one.
There's how important that sacrifice bunt was. Got the man to third base.
Carlson time. Watch the hop. That's a tough hop to handle. You say, well, it's a short hop. Well, you've got this catcher's mitt on your left hand. You've got a runner right on top of you. That short hop came right on the line. Well, we're tied at one. Didn't take long for the Cardinals to get that run back.
Interesting, though, when you saw Carlson on that replay, that I thought he got back on the ball pretty well and was trying to set his feet. Then he took just a little extra hop before his throw and his crow hop to release the baseball.
Chad Weller doing the pitching today, doing the batting right at the moment. Weller did not play in yesterday's ballgame. Weller just one hit in 9 at-bats this year. Puts this one down the right field line. Just foul.
All the line goes to the line. An awful long run for base buyers out there in right field. And that thing started, what, 10 feet fair, quite honestly? And as it went going to line, it tried to fight that wind, which is, you know, blowing gently toward left field, or actually, as we said, is picked up toward left field. But the spin of the ball carried it out of play by about 2 feet off the line.
What you saw there for this run, typical Pleasant Plains baseball. You get a double, well hit ball by Edwards. Sack bunt, sack fly, run. Lau thought he had something there. Center fielder Carlson showing not a whole lot of respect for any power that Weller might have, playing very shallow. Dalton Nibby awaits on deck. Last year, Pleasant Plains, this title ball game fell to Lyle Bay, 10-1 score. folks did not figure they would be back here. Not because of anything within the program, but when you lose 9 seniors and 7 starters off a second place team, it means a lot of the younger guys didn't get a lot of playing time. And then not only that, but you only have 2 seniors on this team. So all those people last year, the majority of this team this year, last year, of course, they were sophomores. Weller will walk with 2 outs. And very quickly, a pinch runner, Adam Sachs. This will be a courtesy runner for the pitcher.
You have Nibby up right now at the 9 hole. You have a chance to run with 2 outs, but you'd have the 9 hitter up. Decision time. At the very least, you've turned the lineup over if you opt not to run. Set base on balls is important.
Number 3, Dalton Nibby.
Nibby, a 347 hitter, the sophomore out of the 9 spot. So if indeed you think of your number 9 hitter as a second leadoff hitter, you may run here instead. Nibby, the high chopper that will sneak into left field. Sachs to pull up at second. The inning continues.
That's the old Baltimore chop, right? For that ball hit right in front of home plate, and then the second bound went over Tyler Rowland's head. Just a fortuitous bounce right there for Pleasant Plains. Watch the ball, the barrel goes straight down. And it was like a Super Bowl.
We made the comment, and this is our third game of the day. We made the comment, I think, on the very first ball that was hit this morning, that this infield itself looked faster today. And I don't know, I had my own working on the lineups. This game was rushed to get started. They did not water this field.
No, not at all.
Games.
No.
Cole Hamilton at the plate with the runner in scoring position. That would be the go-ahead run. Lau delivers. Just misses Hamilton. Want to get that pant leg scraped by a pitch there.
And I don't want to report the fact that I don't know, but I could guess or surmise they didn't give it its normal water during the night with today's forecast.
Pickoff down to second. Sachs is back. He was off there a ways. This is a Pleasant Plains team that will take their chances. Fleeger bounce that one in, though. Pretty long hop half the second inning, 1 run in.
That's been a little bit of a labor for Law this inning. I do not have his pitch count, but it's got to be mid-20s easily this inning. An efficient pitch count is anywhere from like 13 to 15 tops per inning.
And with a 3 ball, 2 strike count, 2 outs. Sachs at second, Nibby at first. Make sure Lau comes home and they'll be off.
An aggressive team who sometimes use a leg move to second.
Tapper to the left side, and that will go through. Sachs will round, he will score, and it's a 2-1 Pleasant Plains lead. That ball was not hit hard, it had enough to get through, but that all developed because the shortstop, Tyler Nunez, was on a bag at second base. Take a look.
Yeah, look at him, he's way out of position. We had talked about a possible leg move, maybe a mix-up. Nunez was not in the shortstop position. He was up towards second like he was gonna get a throw from Lau to bluff the runner back, and just as that occurred, hitch was made, and a ground ball chopper got through the hole. So very fortunate for Pleasant Plains, and quite honestly, a breakdown right there by Byron, not having their positions covered before the pitch.
Nibby will be at second, Hamilton at first, Greer at the plate.
And there was that 2-out walk to Weller, who did not have an extra base hit coming in. Everybody thought, oh, no big deal. But all of a sudden, you get the chop base hit by Nibby, and then the, you know, the ground ball base hit through the vacated hole by Hamilton.
Greer takes the big slow curveball for a strike. Well, if you're into numbers, batting is number 1, Greer. At first base is number 2, Hamilton. At second base, number 3, Nibby. The relevance of that, you determine it.
A little bit of minutia there. Look at that. It's a low-flying plane, isn't it? You can hear the engines.
That's not some storm exploration. This one's off the fist, dropping quickly. Nunez can't get it. Here comes a throw, and in there, sliding safely, is Dalton Nibby. 3-1, Pleasant Plains.
Again, Coach Greer playing with reckless abandon with two outs. You're going to send him. And let's review this inning just a bit as we review this play. This ball's not hit hard. And you don't have to hit the ball hard to get the job done. Just find some green grass. Good throw by the left fielder, Garbutt. And a bang, bang tag. Good call right there. The tag was missed, but go back. Edwards led off with a double, a sacrifice, and a sacrifice fly. Okay, one run basically manufactured, then a walk, a chop, and a flare, and all of a sudden you have a three-run inning.
B, the eighth man to bat in this inning. Great slide at home plate by Nibby. Took his body away from any tag and got that base with his left hand. Runner looking to steal third, and he will do that in a little delay on the first part. Cole Greer. Hamilton thought he could steal third. Greer at first made sure Hamilton was indeed breaking, so a double steal puts runners at second and third, and you have to believe that Cole Hamilton has the green light to steal third base, even with two outs.
Yeah, and we say you never make the third out at third base. This team will run, they'll run, they'll run.
B will go down on strikes. However, in the inning, three runs. There were four hits, a sacrifice bunt, a sacrifice fly, throwing a couple of stolen bases. It all adds up to a 3-1 lead for the Cardinals from Pleasant Plains. Today here in Peoria as we go to the mound, the second in a 3-1 Pleasant Plains lead. Tyler Rowland to lead things off for Byron, a three spot in the top half of this inning for the Cardinals. This one, oh, it comes back into fair territory. Nice run through by Cole Hamilton. That ball was foul, came back fair. Hamilton stayed with it. One pitch, one out.
And then a great pick by Dylan B. So a good play all around, because a lot of third basemen may have given up on this ball. Hits it right on the hands, weakly hit. Look at the ball's foul, and then it hits something, goes fair. What presence of mind on the run through, and then what a nice scoop.
You know, you just look there for Hamilton. Nice little footwork. He had to just make that adjustment to get himself in a throwing angle that he wasn't anticipating. Left-handed hitting Nate Peterson will come to the plate. Peterson, yesterday we talked about his numbers. He was 1-for-4 in the batter's box. Numbers from the mound were outstanding. This one rolled out to Nibby, two up, two down.
Now, we talked about starting this 2A championship game early because of possible weather coming. Here's my question. 3-1 game, two outs, bottom of the second. Both teams watching radar and have parents or coaches or whatever, the same as the IHSA is, the same as the media is. You start to coach the game a little bit differently. I do.
You sure do.
You're coaching this like a five-inning game, like there's three innings left right now. You have to.
Dylan Garbutt, the left fielder. Garbutt scored a run yesterday, hitless in three at-bats, .261 average on the season.
You can feel the temperature hasn't, you know, dropped, but it's definitely cooler. I mean, it hasn't been one of those fronts that you can just feel it going 10 minutes, but it's cooled down a good 6-8 degrees from earlier today.
Weller, the no windup delivery, two outs, he walks him in. It was a two out walk in the top half this inning that really lit the fuse for Pleasant Plains. And yeah, it was the number 8 hitter as well. And here it is in this bottom half of the inning.
Yeah, they had one run in, two outs, no one on. And then they got the walk and three softly hit base hits.
Four, shading Ace Byers around to the right. Pretty big gap in left center if Byers can find him.
Skinner playing pretty deep in respect to that so that he could cut off a gap.
There goes the runner with two outs. The throw down. They got him. Johnny Steinwart throws out Dylan Garbutt. And that will end the Byron threat here in the bottom of the second inning. We head to the third, a two-run lead for Pleasant Plains, looking to go one step higher than their second-place finish last year. First time today that Pleasant Plains will start an inning with the lead. They scored three in the top of the second to overcome a 1-0 Byron lead. In the bottom of the first, this ball game starting about 4 hours earlier than originally scheduled, trying to beat the weather that is moving into the area. Mark, you are a resident meteorologist. That's not pretty.
I do not need to describe that picture tells a thousand words, and that's what we talked about. This is basically right now a three-inning baseball game. And to be perfectly blunt about it, I don't know how fast that storm is moving, but I don't know if we have 45 more minutes, which, you know, would take in a normal situation to play three innings.
Now, we will wait through a weather delay here, so I don't want folks to think, oh, they're going to just stop this game and that will be it.
However, the forecast is for rain for quite a long time.
We've been watching that radar all day, and it's been very slow moving, so not only does it not look good, there's a lot of moisture in it. Johnny Steinwart will lead off the top of the third inning. What a throw that Steinwart made to close out this bottom of the second.
Well, he has been timed at about 2-1-5, which is very, very good. He had a great pitch to throw. It was a fastball up and out. He got rid of that ball in a hurry, right on the money to throw out the would-be base stealer.
Nearly, once again, scrapes the right-handed hitter from Pleasant Plains, Johnny Steinwart. It should be followed by Alex Edwards, and then man who replaced Aaron Hand in right field last inning. That's T.J. Steinwart. And this one is dropping for a hit, the leadoff single from Johnny Steinwart.
Steinwart's dad, a Hall of Fame coach in Springfield. So another coach's son that you know has been around the game, learned the game, and handles himself. See him sprint off the field.
And he will be run for by Jacob Chronister. Again, this is a courtesy runner, not a substitution. T.J. Steinwart is on deck. Mentioned he took the place of Aaron Hand in right field. You might say, wow, okay, Hand drops a fly ball, so they put Steinwart in. No, this was the exact substitution at the exact time of the game yesterday. Hand got his first at bat, then T.J. Steinwart came into the game. Those are the only two seniors, by the way, on this Pleasant Plains roster.
Steinwart came in and got a base hit yesterday in an RBI.
Edwards at that inning started last inning. He rifled a double in the left fielder's head. He was the first of three runs to score in the inning. Short lead at first for Chronister.
Hit the edge, got the call right there. Excellent pitch by Lau.
There goes Chronister. And Edwards did the best he could to try to hit behind the runner, and he had a big hole on that side. That pitch was just a little bit too much in on his hands.
Very impressed with Pleasant Plains' unselfishness trying to hit behind the runner, do what they're coached. See an awful lot of players that, you know, still quote unquote play the game themselves. What I mean by that is still swing away instead of playing the team plays and try to do what the coach wants you to do, hitting behind the runner and moving him along.
There goes Chronister again.
Yeah,
You know, you look at the running, the hitting and running, the stealing of the bases. This is a team a lot of folks like to play for. You know, that style of play where every game you just feel like we're going to put the pressure on. We're going to do this. Yes, you know what? You're going to get thrown out. You may pop up a bunt once in a while. You may hit into a double play rather than, you know, first and third.
Well, I would think when you know, teams that play that way, everybody in the bench is in the game more too, because like, what are we going to do? We're going to steal. We're going to hit and run. I bet she squeezes. You know, you're trying to think with your coach. I think it helps you stay in the game.
Well, and the other part of it is how many we've already had three different pinch runners slash courtesy runners here today. So that's another factor that keeps you into the ball game as well. Again, Cronister. This one is popped up in the air. Flieger makes the catch. He did not. He's headed all the way halfway down that third baseline. Couldn't pull it in. If he makes the catch, Cronister is two-thirds of the way to second base.
So Edwards gets another hack at it right here. And I would assume they'll put Cronister in motion again because we're basically betting on the hitter here.
3-2, nobody out. And this time, Lau, the token toss.
Lau needs to be very conscious, not necessary in this situation, but in a normal steal situation to pause, hold his count, do some different things.
Cronister stays. This is lifted to the right field line. Byers just inside that strike. It's out number one. TJ Steinwert to bat for the first time today. TJ, the older brother of Johnny Steinwert. 149 average here for TJ. Still with one out here, you can play some games here. Lefty hitter.
Yep. A lot much more conscious right now. He can use a step off, he can use a slide step, but he's got to mix them up.
Pretty good hack there from Steinwert. Again, center fielder Carlson in tight. Backs a couple of steps here. 400 feet to dead center field here at Dozer Park. 310 down the lines. Cronister running, Flieger throwing. The tag, he's out. Nice pick there by Nunez, just stayed right there, relaxed, dropped the tag on Cronister, two outs.
And that's exactly what you talked about. Let's break that one down. Great throw by Flieger. Lau had done his job by shortening the lead just a little bit. And then you said sometime you're throwing out, Coach Greer clapped. I mean, he was like, that's okay, we're gonna keep doing what we do. But look at that short hop, and nice tag. He's able to get the ball back down after catching it. So solid play all around.
I'm so impressed by shortstop Tyler Nunez. He is so relaxed out there. That was just a relaxed pick and tag. A lot of people fight that play. They get a little nervous when that ball comes in low and hard. Steinwert goes down swinging. So just like that, the leadoff single is wiped down on a stolen base. Fly out, strikeout. Inning over. 2.5 innings in the book. To the bottom of the third we go in your Class 2A state championship ball game. Pleasant Plains up by two.
I'm going to pull my monitor now and try to supplement the game.
They are moving it up quickly here between innings. Saw the radar a little while ago, and Byron says, let's take advantage here and let's get things rolling, and they do. Base Byers, number 9 hitter, starts it with a single. And again, I truly believe both coaches, as you said earlier, Mark, are playing this as a 5-inning game. That's why Dave Greer is looking, let me add another run.
Right.
Let me see if I can sneak one across here. Byron coming right back. Both these teams trailed in their semifinals, trailed early in the game before coming back to win. Pleasant Plains 5-2 over Freeburg. Byron 6-2 winners over Westmont. To the right side, and that's through for a base hit. Bang, bang, runners first and second for the Tigers.
And both balls hit squarely. Coach Greer making a quick trip to the mound. Yes, he's going to talk about dump bunt defense, and yes, he's just going to say, we're okay. Two squared up baseballs. On the other side, Ray Belskis is talking, and he has a decision with his two-hitter Carlson. Does he try to bunt second and third because you could basically play like this is the middle of the late innings, or is he let the young man that can flat out hit, go ahead and swing away, pull a ball through the left side or through the right side.
Number two man in the order, Austin Carlson, singled and scored in the first inning. That's the Byron run. He'll be at the plate.
Coach Greer walking off, has his notes, has his charts, making a decision where he's going to play his defense. They're expecting bunt. Dylan B can shake his hand, can he?
Yeah, they'll become very good friends here in a second. B in tight. Third baseman Hamilton about even with the bag. Carlson actually got lucky that he fouled that one away and then putting that in play.
Now, if you choose, this would be a great time to put your wheel play, pickoff play on, because they showed bunt very early. They showed the bunt defense very early. If you would see Cole Greer leave, I think you'd see Dalton Nibby come from behind with a throw from the catcher Steinward.
Carlson pushed it down to third base line, and that's a foul ball. That was close, but that was the same area that we saw moments ago when Hamilton fielded it. That ball took a funny hop. There's some tough spots right in that part of the line, about two-thirds of the way down from home plate. And that's two bunt attempts and two foul bunt attempts. I don't think Ray Belskis is looking for Carlson to try to be that exact with that bunt.
No, the rule of thumb is for a drag bunt, for a push, it's on the line or foul. Sacrifice situation, get it on the grass.
Now B, the first baseman, playing well behind the runner at first. That was supposed to be a pinch out. Instead, it could be a double play. And it is. 6:43. Now, if we see that again, Johnny Steinwert was jumping out from behind home plate. Weller threw it down the middle.
He's down talking to his pitcher right now, saying, no, 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 nice pitch. There it is. Watch him come up. There was definitely a cross up. There's no doubt about that. It ends up being a two hopper. Nice turn by Dalton Nibby.
So the turn of events, two failed bunt attempts lead to a double play. Runner at third is Byers. Now a big at bat here for Fleeger. Outfield playing straight away, normal depth. Fleeger to the infield, Nibby. Outfield grass, and Pleasant Plains gets out of it. Runners first and second, nobody out. Carlson can't get a bunt down on two attempts, ends up bouncing to a double play. A couple of pitches later, it's still a 3-1 lead for Pleasant Plains. Overcast skies for your Class 2A championship ball game. We move to the top of the fourth inning and a 3-1 lead for Pleasant Plains. Three runs, five hits and an error for the Cardinals. And for Byron, one run, three hits and one error. Byron got their run in the first. All three Pleasant Plains runs came in the second inning. And we start the fourth with 7-8-9 in the Cardinals order. Zach Ross be followed by Chad Weller and then Dalton Nibby. Actually, we will get a pinch hitter for Weller, second man up in the inning. Left side, scooped nicely there by Roland. One gone.
Now that was a good play by Roland. You might say it was easy. He had to range to his left, but he kept his glove down, ground to the grass the whole time. Would be able to adjust if the ball came up. Watch his hands. Watch the glove down, 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 down. Good fundamental play. Work from the bottom on up.
So Dave Greer will go to his bench once again. Aiden Sachs. Sachs, who is a pinch runner earlier, courtesy runner, that is, for Chad Weller. This will be a substitution here. Sachs will step in. Weller walked. Sachs ended up running for him, and eventually scored on a single by Hamilton. Sex has to roll that shoulder in, but the strike is called on that inside corner. Sachs, a 5'8", 140-pound freshman. Dave Greer not afraid to run freshman here in the state championship ballgame. He has a few in his roster, and they've been on the bases.
We saw that Dave Greer has been pinch running early in games. I don't know if he'd pinch hit this early, quite honestly, for his pitcher. He's going to re-enter. But he's thinking, I might only be here for two more innings, is the thought process.
Sachs with 5 hits and 20 at-bats this year. Mentioned Weller before, he had just 1 hit and 9 official at bats. Lau delivers. Oh my. That curveball hit him, and Sachs just swung. And that's a strikeout.
That's a strange one.
I sometimes you do see that, but not to that extent where it hits you in the midsection or almost goes behind you. Here it is.
He swings, that ball's gonna get right in, literally right in the middle of his chest or his stomach. So that ball had to have broken what, 15, 18 inches? And how he got so far in front of that was unbelievable.
Now that's not one that Aiden Sachs will replay too often, I don't think. Two quick outs here to Dalton Nibby. Nibby had a single in that 3-run second inning. Number 9 hitter in the order, you can call him your second leadoff hitter.
You know, Dave, pretty good crowd for both teams, Byron and Pleasant Plains, but again, pretty quiet to be honest with you. Mm-hmm. They've turned out, but.
This has been a quiet turn.
Yes.
That's called strike on Nibby, 3-1. He's taking all the way. And Nibby's gonna get things started here with 2 outs. It brings us to the top of the order in Cole Hamilton. He's been on base twice today. Let off this game at the walk. Single, drove in a run his last time up.
You know, Nibby turns the lineup over like he did in the second inning. You got some danger in Hamilton, Greer, and B. Those guys coming up. So don't think that it's 2 outs. The Pleasant Plains done.
Slow curveball. Hamilton didn't like it. Didn't like the pitch. The call is a strike. It was a good one. Didn't want to go biting on that one. Pretty good lead there by Nibby. He takes off, first move. He'll try to beat the throw to second. And he's gonna try to beat a throw to third. He's gonna have to get down here. And he's in there. So Nibby will get credit for the stolen base. The error on the throw from the first baseman, Nate Peterson, will advance him to third.
What I like about this play is Nibby, you can tell the way they're coached. He's gonna outrun that throw. It gets into, but look, he gets right back up. There's never a doubt. He said, this is just the way I play, the way we play. We're gonna force the defense to get the job done. He just outran the baseball there.
Roland's tag, not in time, and with 2 outs and a runner at third, count now 0-2 to the hitter, Cole Hamilton. And that will score a run. It will be 4-1. Hamilton flying to second base. 2 out double, Cole Hamilton. Two quick outs in the inning. Nibby, a single, stolen base, goes to third on an error. Hamilton brings him home with a double, and it's a 3-run advantage for the Cardinals.
We had just got done commenting how, with 2 outs, the top of the order, Pleasant Plains definitely not done. There's an 0-2 pitch that he laces inside the line, able to keep it fair.
Paul Greer today, he has a single. Stolen base. Remember, Hamilton has stolen third in this game. Stole third yesterday as well. Up the middle, that's right where Nunez is standing. Pleasant Plains gets a run. They do it with a couple of hits. The RBI double from Cole Hamilton. And halfway home here in your 2A state championship ball game, the Cardinals, second place finishers last year, lead Byron 4-1. Ben Reibel to lead things off. Byron needs to get back to work. They scored a run in the first. They've been quiet the last two innings, at least on the scoreboard. After a runner at third last inning. You know, we look back into the 9-1 and 2 spots in the Pleasant Plains order. We talk about the speed from Nibby, Hamilton, and Greer. Oh boy, they have produced base hits today. Out of the 7 hits the Pleasant Plains have, they have 5 of them.
5 for 7 and throwing a base on ball. So on base, 6 out of 8 right there. That's productivity. And you definitely described Nibby right. He is the second leadoff man. So they feel good with him at the plate. Turn the lineup back over for the heavy lumber of Hamilton, Greer, B, and Steinwert.
First baseman B, one out. Dan Lau fouled out to the left fielder, Dylan Skinner, his first time up. Skinner recognizes Lau, the left hand intercepts in the box, and he moves towards that line in left field. This ball's hit to left center field. Ross, the center fielder, runs it down. Zach Ross. Ball was hit pretty well.
Ross with a good drop step. He dropped his right leg, headed straight direction to the point where he knew the baseball was going to be. Watch his right leg. See that? His first movement goes to the point where he knows the ball's going to land and tracks that down. Very good jump. Very, very solid center field play.
Brings up Tyler Rowland. Rowland, 350 hitter on the season. He grounded out his first time up. Weller looking for a very quiet inning here, but he's not going to get it. Big hole on that right side. Rowland found it. Two out hit. It's Tyler Rowland down at first base. Fourth hit of the game for Byron. 7 hits for Pleasant Plains.
Weller continues to pitch to contact. I'm impressed with how he's working very expediently and efficiently. Good rhythm, good mechanics.
The only strikeout he's had today came to the first batter he faced in this game. Tyler Nunez struck out to lead off the bottom of the first inning.
His team has made one error behind him.
That little bat wiggle. Now he'll let it go. Jumps over the glove of Nibby into right field. So Byron with 2 outs here in the 4th. Not going away.
Well, you don't win 36 games by going away.
Now we'll bring up Dylan Garbutt.
Put an error on the board on that play.
Garbutt walked, was caught stealing. Last time he was up in his spot in the order. That's the number 8 slot in the Byron order. Took a pretty good cut at this one. Wind will push this towards left center, and that's where Zach Ross will settle underneath it. So a couple of 2-out base runners, but nothing crosses the plate. Through 4, it's 4-1. Top of the 5th inning, and that's significant here. 5 innings, official game if we get bad weather moving in, and it's a 4-1 lead for Pleasant Plains, and your number 3 hitter in the order, Dylan B will lead things off. B, token show of a bunt. Don't know how serious he was. Big time hitter, 378 average, 46 runs scored, 28 RBI, 7 triples, 3 home runs. Who'd you say Dave Greer compared him to? Andy Van Slyke.
Andy Van Slyke, a name out of the past in the 80s when the Pirates were perennially making the playoffs. 6'2", 195, chiseled young man. 51 stolen bases with a 6'2", 195 frame. You'd think at a high school level, you're not, you know, athletic. You'd be maybe a little bit of a lumberjack. No, this guy is just athletic in every sense of the word.
Dan Lau working in his fifth inning. He has struck out 4 today, giving up 7 hits.
I didn't ask Coach Greer this, but I bet you I would know the answer. Usually you ask a coach, does so-and-so have a green light? I would say everyone has a green light unless he has a sign, please not, you know, no, not this time. I mean, you're free to go, and he might have a sign, I think, that says no, you know, for whatever reason.
I think we saw a little bit of that when we've seen Hamilton steal third in non-traditional situations. B, rung up on strikes. 5 strikeouts now in 4 1/3 innings for Lau. Had that weird second inning when 3 runs were scored. There were 3 hits, couple of balls off the hands. Sacrifice bunt, stolen bases. 3 runs second, the difference in this game. Calling it straight back is Johnny Steinworth.
Sacrifice fly thrown in as well. Yep. So, yeah, 3 hits. Let's call it, none of them hit hard. I mean, they all found ground and all very effective, putting 3 up on a board.
Digger, a little casual flip past his pitcher. Folks in Pleasant Plains, look at this roster, see 2 seniors, and they think this could be a fun year in 2015. You know, and how many times, though, do you see, Mark, you see maybe a class moving through, whether it be middle school, junior high, freshman, you say, oh, man, when they get to be seniors, and sometimes it just never happens. But yet their junior year, sophomore junior years, things click. No automatic that it's going to happen the following year.
Well, that's what we were talking about in an earlier ball game, about the chemistry and about the character. Those things have to come together. And when personalities come together as one, you have something magical if you have the talent already in place. But sometimes personalities fall apart, and those are the teams we don't talk about because those are the teams that aren't here. Teams can self-destruct.
On the flip side here, you have Byron playing in his state championship ball game. They had a class they were following all along, and here indeed here they are.
Absolutely.
Jacob Cronister once again will run for Johnny Steinward, who's hit by that pitch.
And we know as coaches that, you know what, sometimes coaches can lose a team at any level, and sometimes coaches can bring a team that much closer together. And coaching decisions outside the lines are usually not seen by people. It's when do you jump on a team? When do you cuddle a team? When do you, you know, all those things that take place is you have to know your personnel and try to mold them as one. All the individual conversations and the role conversations.
Curveball finds its mark for Alex Edwards. He's the designated hitter today, batting for Dylan Skinner. 1 for 2, doubled and scored in the second. Cronister goes. Slow curveball. Fleeger would never have had a chance, even if he had been able to catch that cleanly. Went on first move and got a 57 mile per hour breaking ball to work with as well. Fifth stolen base of the day by the Cardinals. Good pitch right there from Lau. He's set. He went and he right there on the ankles of Edwards.
So in 11 innings, the Cardinals have 10 stolen bases in this tournament. My goodness.
You know, this is in the state finals. This is not against some team that comes in with a 4-15 record. Byron 36 and 5. Well, we were talking, what, Thursday, you know, the stolen base, individual stolen base numbers for some of these players. You say, well, how can they have that many stolen bases? Well, it's laid out right in front of us here.
Some of those we're talking about. Hamilton 29, Greer 47, B 51.
And now off the bench, Cronister gets a stolen base. Nunez plants, throws. Peterson can't come up with it. Cronister will come in to score. And a second base will go Edwards. And it's a 5-1 game.
Nunez did a great job planting his back foot. Had some authority on the throw, but just short hopped the first baseman. Peterson tried to scoop it, couldn't get the job done. Again, a high bounding ball. Looking at Plant, he's throwing that ball from the outfield grass and just short hops Peterson, who did his best to try to knock it down, but to no avail.
Five to one lead, five runs, eight hits, and two errors. That error there to a score. Cronister is the third of the game for Byron, and we will have a pitching change. Dan Lau goes 4 1/3 innings. This is Dennis Reedy. There is Lau. He'll go back to first base. Reedy comes into this ball game, 5'9", 170 pound junior.
8-1, 1.54 earned run average. So that's a good junior to have coming back. 38 strikeouts, 14 bases on balls in his 59 innings pitched. And his job is to hold it right here because Byron already looking at a 5-1 deficit.
47-14. This is your 2A state championship ball game. If everything goes well, we will still have a third place game in 2A. A little bit out of order from what a lot of folks would expect, but again, with pending rain, going to get a state champion in 2A, and if you get that third place game played here today in this situation, it's a bonus. Remember, next week, Class 3A, 4A baseball come your way here on the NFHS Network and IHSA.TV will come to you from Joliet. TJ Steinwart will get his second at bat here today. He came on to replace Aaron Hand. He's back in the third inning.
Whoa, a little bit of wind action.
Runner at second is Edwards. He's running for himself here. Remember, he was run for early in this game. Steinwart, a good bunt down. Quickly off the mound, Reedy. He airmails this one. And coming in to score will be Edwards to second, and maybe to third is TJ Steinwart. The throw to third. Gets away there, and TJ Steinwart motors for home. He'll circle the bases.
That personifies Pleasant Plains Cardinal baseball. That was everybody in motion, forcing plays. He had a new pitcher on the hill, and Reedy, he tested him right away. Once the ball got on the right field line, it was time to put speed in motion on the bases. We're gonna drop the barrel right over the top of the ball.
The lead goes to 7-1.
Reedy threw that ball off his back foot. That was the first mistake. And then the rest, they say, is history, as there is no doubt Steinwart knew what he was doing, knew where the baseball was at, and they've opened a big, big advantage.
Zach Ross waves and misses at this one. A three-run second, one in the fourth, three more here in the fifth inning, still only one out.
A
up the middle, under the gloves, and past to diving Nunez. The inning rolls on with the ninth hit of the day for the Cardinals.
A little bit reminiscent of the 1A championship, because you have so much separation. You don't have that edge of every pitch right now. Now, of course, Byron's going to have something to say about that when they get their hacks, but right now, Pleasant Plains total command of this baseball game. They've done it with base running, speed, the bunting game, the pressure game, an exciting style of play.
Byron led this game 1-0 in the first inning, but then Pleasant Plains took control of it about 2 minutes later, scoring three in the second. Chad Weller back into the game. Of course, he re-entered as a pitcher, and Aiden Sachs pinch hit for him in the fourth. Weller came right back on the mound the following inning. And he will put the bunt down. After the bobble, Reedy is able to get Weller at first base. You know, you love those situations where you have Chad Weller, who would come into this game only batted 9 times, only had 1 hit. You give him an opportunity, a game situation where he can bunt the ball. So what Weller's done is 2 at-bats. He has walked. His spot in the order eventually scored a run, and he gets a sacrifice. That's not bad for somebody who's 1-for-9 coming in.
Now, definitely knowing his role, contributing to his offense, his walk scored with a courtesy runner, and then he moves his teammate Ross into scoring position for Nibby, who's 2-for-2 on the day.
Got the Nibby Hamilton Greer connection coming through right now with 2 outs.
5 out of 7 and a walk.
Now the throw back behind the runner. Ross is able to dive back.
You know, go back to Nibby's first at bat in the second inning. He's the one that had that high chop, which was, let's call it, fortuitous at best. But once you get that first hit on the board, his second one was hit with much more authority. He's on the good for a big day.
Now the pick at second. Ross in trouble. He'll be tagged out by Roland. But 3 more runs cross the plate here in the fifth. We'll head to the bottom. The lead has been extended to 6. Uh-oh, umbrella is starting to poke out here in Peoria. We'll go to the bottom of the fifth inning. Very crucial, especially for Pleasant Plains, that they get this bottom half of this inning in. Myers misses that one by a foot.
Clarify for people, Pleasant Plains needs to retire 3 more outs for this to be an official game after 5.
And that 0-2 pitch, Johnny Steinway really working hard back there to make sure that ball stays in front of him. Great pitch from Weller. What a great pitch. Not a strikeout pitcher here today. That is just his second, but he gets one right there on a bender.
You see the Cardinals not even throwing the ball around. The ball went right back from Steinward to Weller trying to get this game moving. They know what 2 outs means. See it right there? No, we're not throwing it around.
Back to the top of the order, and rain falling here at Dozier Park. Tyler Nunez at the plate. This one may stay in play with the wind. It will push it back for B and push it forward, but he stays with it. Not as easy as that looked off the bat.
I was going to say that was not an easy catch, and that was just a pop up to the right side, but B was back by the tarp. Watch him sprint backwards, and then the wind has really changed. The rain has picked up just a little bit, and he has to sprint with the underhand basket catch.
Austin Carlson with 2 outs. And there is no take here. It's hit for Byron. Why not? Weller has only walked 1 batter today.
Yeah, he's been pounding the strike zone. Pitching to contact.
Well, you look back at different key plays in the game. Of course, in any game, you have a number. Of course, the way Pleasant Plains had run the bases, but I look back to Carlson's last at bat. He had runners first and second, nobody out. Bunted foul twice in sacrifice bunt attempts. And then bounced into a double play. And all of a sudden, a big rally at that time when it was just a 3-1 game. All of a sudden, rally over.
Yeah, they weren't able to dent when they had a chance in the third inning.
And a strikeout from Weller. You talk about a quick inning right there. That's what Pleasant Plains did. This game is not over yet, but we've finished five. It's a regulation game, and it's a 7-1 lead in your 2A state championship. It was not umbrella giveaway day here today at the IHSA state baseball finals. Those folks brought them in and did a nice job of hiding them somewhere, but they have come into play here as we start the sixth inning.
Well, the weather forecast is proving correct because they told us we're going to have rain middle late afternoon. It's here right now, very light. We'll continue to play on. But what was it, Caddyshack? I think it's going to blow through. It was a monsoon. I don't know. We're supposed to get some of that nasty yellow and red colors coming at some point.
Dalton Nimmy to lead it off here in the top of the sixth inning. To the left side. One out. Tyler Rowland across the infield to Dan Lau. First time that Nibby has been retired today. Back to the top of the order. Cole Hamilton. He has not been retired. A walk, an RBI single, and an RBI double.
He was 1-for-2 yesterday, so 3-for-4 officially in the tournament.
On in relief, Dennis Reedy came on last inning. He's charged with one of those three runs. And that was the crazy one, the bunt that was thrown all over this field. It allowed TJ Steinwerk to make a left turn three different times and end up scoring a run. Hamilton will keep that hot bat going, his third hit of the day. Pleasant Plains has reached double digits in the hit column. That's their 10th.
You don't think they're going to shut down the running game, do you? Not a chance.
Get ready. You may be bunting and running, hitting and running, running and hitting. Cole Greer, the freshman shortstop. He watched last year as his dad's team finished second in the state to Lyle. Hamilton, big lead at first. We'll get back. Right now with the 7-1 lead, it's much easier. Pleasant Plains batting with that lead in this light rain, and it is playing defense out there. Hamilton goes. Greer pulls back in a bunt. Another stolen base for Hamilton. That's his third of the day.
So that's six on the tournament, or six on the day, 11 for 12 in the tournament. You know, when you think about that, those are just numbers, but think about 11 more bases. I mean, closer to home plate without a double plays not being in order. Things like that, just unbelievable.
They used to pick, have the media vote on all tournament team or players of the tournament. They don't do that anymore, but if they did, Cole Hamilton's name would be on a few ballots.
Yep, no doubt. It's fun to watch.
Well, if you could like draw a model of a leadoff hitter, he'd be right there in the frame. Surprised they haven't turned on the lights here at Dozier Park. Rears look like he won upon each of these pitches, but he's got that count 3-1 in his favor right now.
It's so amazing right now because Reedy, he's just as concerned with Hamilton as he is with Greer. That's what base running does to you.
Hamilton looking to steal third. Uh-oh. Not this time. Reedy got the ball there in a hurry. Hamilton did not get a good jump. Thought maybe he might have slammed on his brakes there and retreated. But he'll run into that tag. And with that, there are now two outs and a 3-2 count on Greer.
Byron did a much better job as a team with a hold that time. Nice throw by Flieger, but Nunez did a good job holding him on.
Nice sliding catch made by the center fielder, Austin Carlson, and the threat dies quickly. We'll head to the bottom of the sixth inning in a 7-1 lead for the Cardinals from Pleasant Plains. Bottom of the sixth, Byron down by six. Six outs to work with. Chad Weller's been dealing since allowing that one run in the first inning. Weller's given up only four hits today. Struck out three. Number three hitter, Jack Fleeger's rain starts to come down a little bit heavier now.
Weller came in, as we had mentioned, in the open with a 1.33 earned run average, 85 strikeouts. He doesn't overpower you. Well, that's a pretty good ratio, but I tell you what, he's around it, he's around it, he's around it. He gets borderline calls, his defense makes plays. And he's pitched a very good pace, keeping his defense in good rhythm and good mental state.
Two hopper to Hamilton at third. Good speed by Flieger, he beats it. Oh, he got down the line in a hurry.
Well, I'm impressed by Flieger right there, because Hamilton did everything he should have done to make that play, but Flieger takes a ground ball and just busts his tail and just outruns the play. Watch how quickly he gets out of the box. And instead of, oh, I'm out 5-3, he sprints it through, doesn't slow down, doesn't slide, and just beats the throw. Great hustle.
Ben Reibel, the designated hitter, batting for the second baseman, Austin Van Lankville. Seven runs, 10 hits, two errors for Pleasant Plains. One run, five hits, and five errors for the Tigers from Byron.
The only thing that's consistent with every coach is, if you ask them what they want their team to do, play hard. And for example, Flieger just played hard. He played the game hard.
Well, you never know.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, that's a routine ground ball, but now he's at first base with a hit, and he's at first base for his team.
Yeah.
And all he had was 90 feet of solid effort. Went way outside, missed on that 0-2 count.
Either way, Byron still has six outs left. Stranger things can happen. Stranger comebacks have happened. And they don't have to get it all in this inning. But quite clearly, it would be very advantageous to cut into the lead. You know, make it 7-3, 7-4.
Skinner, the left fielder, playing next to the line, a center fielder. Zach Ross shading a little bit to right center, so a pretty big gap for Reibel in left center field. Reibel, big RBI man for Byron.
Jeff Boyer, Byron first base coach, the head football coach for the Tigers. He didn't want any part of making that play.
Reibel right through it, got just a piece of it. Steinwart hangs on, and that's the first out here in the sixth.
High heat, hard to get when the ball's above your hands. Extremely difficult to keep the barrel, to get the barrel back up above the ball where you want to hit it. So a quality pitch right there against Reibel.
Bring up Dan Lau, started this game on the mound over at first base right now. Lau today in the batter's box, blown out, actually fouled out to the left. Lined out to center. They're shading him to swing quite late. He'll pull it right side and pass B. Flieger, look at him fly around the bases. In at third easily.
We talk about the speed at the top of the lineup for Pleasant Plains. That Flieger can flat out run, can he?
Well, he got down from home to first, and then you look up, the ball's not hit that softly. You look up, he's already around second full speed and just cruised to third. Two hits in the inning, one gone. Runners at first and third for Tyler Rowland.
Would you say in your best meteorological experience that this is the hardest it's been raining thus far?
Right at the moment.
Yeah.
It has that look about it. You know, we aren't privy to the clouds behind us where this is actually moving from, but this doesn't look like it's going to stop anytime soon. And that's not looking at the map. See Roland looking down to Ray Belskis, his head coach Byron, 36-5 this year, Pleasant Plains, 30 wins and 11 losses. There's a stretch in the middle of the season for Pleasant Plains. They lost 7 times in the 11-game stretch. Obviously, have regrouped quite nicely, thank you. 10-0 and 10-4 wins in the regional. 2-0, 6-5 in the sectional. Knocked off Williamsville 6-5, then shut out Monticello, a super sectional before the win yesterday over Freeburg at 5-2. And that walk will load the bases as the rain comes down a little bit harder yet.
And we had talked about that Williamsville game. They lost 11-0 and had to play Williamsville then in the sectional final. They come back and beat them 6-5. And we talked about also Fleegers legging out that hit and just cutting this to, you know, 7-3, 7-4. Now they got the bases juiced and only one out. And they're a hit away from basically regaining a little bit of momentum and a little bit of hope.
There your look at Ray Belskis. He informs our home plate umpire, Tim Griffin, that Nate Peterson will re-enter the game. Peterson came out when Dennis Reedy came on to pitch. So we will have a new pitcher if we get to the top of the seventh inning. Pitch a strike. Weller from the full windup. Tying run is still sitting in the Byron dugout. Things could get interesting here in a hurry.
Mitch Kaler, that's right, warming up for Pleasant Plains down the right field side.
Kaler, an iron arm, got the win yesterday, went 7 innings. He pitched a complete game victory for Pleasant Plains in the sectional semis, 3 hits shutout, went 8 1/3 scoreless innings a couple of days later for his sectional championship. Throws every day, doesn't throw hard, but he just throws and throws. We may see him before this is over. That was a quick conversation for Dave Greer. Infield breaks up, the outfield breaks up. 2 balls and 1 strike here to Peterson. Pretty key batter in this ball game right here, whether the rain is coming down or not.
No doubt. Peterson threw Kaler threw just 79 pitches yesterday. He'll bounce back.
And can't find that one.
Down the left field bullpen, Zach Cogswell is warming up for the Byron Tigers.
Two pitch. Do it again. Unless they turn two, they do, because Peterson, up, he's safe at first. Peterson, I think, slipped and fell on his way from home to first, so does not get the double play. That throw pulled the first baseman B off the bag, so give Flieger a run scored. Advance Lau to third. Roland is thrown out at second. Here's a look back at it.
Good delivery to second. Then the double clutch by Nibby.
Oh, B was off the bag.
And where was B?
B was not even thinking double play. That would have been an inning-ending double play if B was on the bag.
So mark that one down. They basically give him an out. They give an at-bat here to Garbutt. See if he can take advantage and extend the inning, move the line.
Peterson fell down on his way to first. I looked and I thought, okay, Pleasant Plains will be happy to get one out. And Peterson was sprawled halfway between home plate and first base. And it works out for the Tigers. It's a 7-2 game. guess in the end, it truly is the way the play would have happened in a normal situation. Get the force and second, a run scores, and you get your out and you play on.
Now, Kaler's ready, comes sprinting back to the dugout. I don't know if he's ready, but he's supposed to get out of the rain.
Yep, it's out of the rain, yeah.
No, that young man wants the ball. His arm can take it.
Garbett at the plate, walking a flyout today. Rams off the glass here at our sweet level. You can see the rain falling in front of us, but if you look into the Pleasant Plains and Byron dugouts, you see the water splashing in there. Drops. Garbett taking some pretty good hacks here on Weller.
Yeah, you first described the first drops and you said, you know, we have rain. Now it is like steady. That's a great picture right there. It's heavier drops.
Our umpires want to get through this inning at the very least. Pretty good lead at first base as Garbett continues to fight at the plate. Peterson at first, Lau at third.
Now we know once a game starts, it's quote unquote in the hands of the umpires, their decision. And yeah, I have to wonder in relationship with the IHSA how much they have to say, you know, about the game itself, not just the turnip, the game itself.
And this will load the bases. Peterson was running on that 2-2 pitch, anticipating they were not going to make a play on him. And here comes Greer. He's coming out here in a hurry, and I think we're going to see Mitch Kaler follow him shortly. Pretty determined, direct route to the mound for Greer.
A little bit of animated conversation right there, just a challenge conversation. And he wants number 15.
Kaler to come in. Weller gets a nice hand. He'll leave with this team on top 7-2. Tying run is in the on-deck circle. So Kaler will come right into the spot in the order for Weller.
So let's take a look at Kaler first, his season-long numbers, and then we'll check what he did yesterday. He is just a junior, 5'10", 190. Came into this tournament with an 11-2 record, now 12-2.
And we are going to have a delay. They are rolling the tarp out. So with the bases loaded, two outs, Mitch Kaler will be on the mound when we return. When that will be, we are not sure. Folks with those umbrellas, as protective as they are, they're going to scramble and head upstairs onto the concourse level. This is your Class 2A state championship game. The call has been made to roll this out. The Volunteers here today at Dozer Park. Be busy people as they cover that dirt area very quickly. It is raining in Peoria in your Class 2A state championship ball game. We have two outs here in the bottom of the sixth inning. Pleasant Plains leads it 7-2. Make sure you stay with us. We'll step aside for a while, see if we can get this weather to clear the area and complete this 2A game. But your score as of now, bottom of the sixth is Pleasant Plains 7, Byron 2. Welcome back to Peoria and Dozer Park, where Mother Nature has officially ended this Class 2A state baseball tournament. You are looking at your Class 2A champions, the Pleasant Plains Cardinals, 7-1 winners over Byron. I'm Dave Bernhardt, along with Hall of Fame coach Mark Lindo. And Mark, championship ball game. The score reverts back to the last complete inning. That's why the 7-1 final. But in this championship game, Pleasant Plains did what they've done all year. They pick up their 31st win by hitting and running and making things happen.
A lot of havoc on the bases, a lot of pressure on the defense. Coach Greer had his team in motion. They played with reckless abandon. They played like a champion tonight.
On the other side for the Byron Tigers, they finished their year at 36-6. What a great year for 6 3-year starters.
Well, unbelievable way they went out. They had a purpose, they had a goal all year long. They got to the big stage and just didn't have enough here tonight. But second place will feel better as the days go along.
5 hours of rain, no sign of letting up, but it doesn't matter to those folks right there from Pleasant Plains. Their second state baseball championship, and it comes here this year in 2014 in Peoria. Thanks for joining us this weekend, everybody. We'll do it all over again next weekend in Joliet for Class 3A and 4A. For our entire crew and for my partner, Mark Lindo, I'm Dave Bernhardt. Thanks for joining us, everybody.
And my apologies for missing number 17, Alan.